20% of marriages are unhappy. And in 50% of those, one or both spouses has a mood disorder. And where one spouse suffers from depression, the divorce rate is 9 times higher. So how do we know if our moods are normal? Today I want to talk to you about physical issues that will interfere with all relationships, especially your marriage. These are the mood disorders: depression, anxiety, and bipolar disorder. Mood disorders are so common that whenever I meet a couple who are struggling with their relationship, the first thing I do is an assessment of their moods to see if either of them has problems with depression, anxiety, or bipolar disorder. 15% of the population has a mood disorder, but 80% don't realize it because the symptoms are mild and not bad enough to go for help. I call them the walking wounded. They're unhappy and they're looking for someone to blame it on, so they look for anything in their life that's causing stress or conflict, and that usually means their husband or wife, and that really increases tension. So a mood disorder can magnify any unresolved issue in the marriage and make it overwhelming. 20% of marriages are unhappy, and in 50% of those, one or both spouses has a mood disorder. And where one spouse suffers from depression, the divorce rate is 9 times higher. So how do we know if our moods are normal? We have no way to measure moods, so we can't test a person to see if they're normal. So I've created my own definition of normal mood. Just compare yourself to this definition and see if you're normal. Normal mood is being relaxed, content, concentrating, in control of your thoughts, with a clear mind consistently. Now you're right, I don't know anyone like that either. We all struggle with our mood at times. So how can you tell if you need help with your moods? Well, here's an easy way to separate a normal down mood, which I call discouragement, from depression, which is a medical illness that needs treatment. Discouragement is usually triggered by negative life events, and it clears with time. It only affects part of your life. You may be down about work, but fine at home. You still feel connected to God and that life is worth living. But most importantly, a person who is discouraged is able to concentrate and control their thoughts. Depression is quite different. Depression usually lasts for years. Most of the people who came to see me had been down and gradually worsening for at least 20 years. A depressed person loses interest in most activities of life and feels hopeless. They will often feel abandoned or even punished by God. Any stress or disappointment can become overwhelming. Now, here are the most important symptoms to watch for. When a person is depressed, they can't shut their mind off from continuous down, sad, negative, anxious thoughts, and they can't concentrate. It's very important to determine which kind of down mood you may be experiencing. If you're just discouraged, then time and counseling may be all you need. If you're depressed, though, you need to see a doctor for medications as well as a counselor. With anxiety disorder, you can't shut your mind off, but the thoughts are predominantly worry and fear. With bipolar disorder, your moods swing from depression to high-energy drivenness, where you can't shut off your mind with positive, ambitious thoughts, and it can make you very impatient and irritable. There are medications that can correct these chemical imbalances and restore thought control, so you can get back to normal mood. And when you're feeling better, it will be so much easier to resolve the issues in your marriage. You can find lots more information about mood disorders and a self-assessment checklist in my book, Emotionally Free, and on my website, drgrantmullen.com. And if you see yourself described there, take the checklist to your doctor to discuss treatment. And see a counselor. They can really help you think differently. Don't let your marriage be the victim of your moods. Check yourself out and take action if you need to.